Oh, Dr. Livingstone, I presume. Glasgow Cathedral was thought to have been built on the site of St Kentigern's tomb and marks the birthplace of the city of Glasgow. It is one of Scotland's most magnificent medieval buildings and the only one on the Scottish mainland to survive the Reformation of 1560 intact.
In the 1800s, they bought glass from Munich in Germany. But because of the Industrial Revolution in Glasgow, it was steel, shipbuilding, it was a very, very dirty city. So the stained glass got so dirty, no light came through it. So in the mid-1900s, the 20th century, all the glass that you see in this part of the cathedral is really fairly modern. And St Mungo, who's the patron saint, came here in 540 AD. But the first stone laid for the church was 1136. They say that no matter where you stand, John the Baptist there's eyes will follow you and his toes will point towards you.
His toes will point toward us. Let's see that. All right. So, true, true. He is pointing toward me.
Walk round to the St Mungo's tomb and then walk out. And it was it's an important pilgrimage to Catholics.
Oh, by Robert Lovett's Stevenson family.
Now, the Stevenson family in Glasgow were very wealthy. They built over 250 of
John
them.
John said the Stevenson family built lighthouses. I could even read that. How about that? I find it interesting that St. Mungo is prevalent here in Scotland because I think of Harry Potter. What did St. Mungo do that he became the patron saint and pilgrims?
I'll tell you.
This is St. Mungo's chapel.
It's Mungo Chapel, and it's the tomb of St. Mungo, and this is where his remains are.
Oh, his remains are still here?
His remains are still here, yes.
I mean his real remains, yes. Not just a little tiny piece of his finger or something like that? Or they
no, they say the most of his remains there, although some... But the story of St. Mungo, his original name was called Kentigern, which was a Celtic name. His mother became pregnant out of wedlock when her father wasn't happy with it. So he put her in a little canoe without any oars, pushed her into the River Forth with the view that she would drown. She survived because the canoe ended up in a religious settlement, St. Serves. So St. Mungo was born, he was known as Kentigern then. And the reason he's known became a saint, you've got to do certain miracles. There's a story in Glasgow, the coat of arms, you'll see it over here.
Now yeah. I know, that's the coat of arms of Glasgow.
So here's a bird that never flew, here's a tree that never grew, here's a bell that never rang. I'm going to tell you shortly about here is the fish that never swam. We had the king and the queen of Strathclyde. The king gave the queen a ring, the queen gave it to her lover. King found out, took the ring off the lover, threw it into the River Clyde, then said to the Queen, I want you to see you wearing the ring. She didn't have it. Her lover never had it, it was now in the Clyde. She went to St Mungo for help, and he sent one of his servants down to the river and caught a salmon, a fish, and inside the fish's mouth was the ring. So she got the ring back and was able to wear it in front of the King and saved the day for her. That's the Queen's chair and her husband, Duke of Edinburgh, so nobody else is allowed to sit in these chairs. So these translations, but it's Jehovah is for me, against me, who he is. My life is in heaven with those who live forever. He will bring me from the world, for it is vanity. Hasten his majesty, how in his strength, here and there, glory. So they're not quite sure of the translation, but that's the best translation.
My God. But it's you said there were no Jews in Scotland at the time.
So they think it was someone travelling through Scotland at the time. Probably the best view of the cathedral. We see if you look up there, where's the St Andrew's cross,
yes.
The blue background, it's called the saltire. That was the sheriff's chair or the bishop's chair, and they would actually view the congregation from there.
The holes in the doors are from the bullets during the fighting during the Reformation. And the doors are original. University of Glasgow started in this small sacristy in the 1400s. And that's the hidden door that the Archbishop could escape out of the church or for his life or whatever. Thank you.